Last year, government, business and labor held a jobs summit and agreed on joint steps to be taken in order to increase job creation and reduce the rate of unemployment, especially youth unemployment in the country. At the time, the unemployment rate was at 27%. A year on, the unemployment rate is worse. It has shot up to a record level of 29%. For FEDUSA, the reason behind that is easy to pinpoint.
It's quite clear cut. If Eskom cannot guarantee supply of electricity, unfortunately the lights go down. We've seen the effect throughout the system, whether it's big enterprises, whether it's small or micro enterprises, and as a result you've had short time, you have people laid off on jobs, and at the same time we are not able to sustain that cyclical economic growth that we are looking for.
President Cyril Ramaphosa has instructed Eskom to ensure that there is no load shedding during the current festive season. FEDUSA says that should be the case throughout next year for the economy to grow and create jobs.
We are hoping that the commitments that have been made via Eskom board chair Jabu Mabuza will continue to sustain not only beyond the 13th of January but to the ordinary South African consumers, to the businesses as such, so that we can have greater stability and that we can start improving the figures out there in terms of the number of jobs that we want to create.
FEDUSA is non-committal regarding the renewed debate about the privatization of state-owned enterprises. The issue is expected to heat up next year with major trade unions such as NUMSA and the NUM and even the EFF vowing to embark on rolling mass action to oppose attempts to privatize SOEs.
That is a matter that is still subject to review. As I said to you, from the FEDUSA perspective, we cannot deal with the matter in terms of a one-size-fits-all. There are varying degrees in terms of how these SOEs are operating. So ultimately, we have to deal with them on a case-by-case basis. But intervention is most certainly required.
FEDUSA moves into the future without Dennis George, its public face over the last 20 years. The former general secretary was sacked earlier this year over his involvement in a controversial business venture. He formally parted ways with the Union Federation after reaching a settlement at the CCMA last week. Bongani Mutwa, SABC News, Johannesburg.